I gathered you grew up nice and sheltered with mama's pretty stories and you're all made up fury.
And mama gave me a magic clicker. Well, yes, I think it's true and fair to say.
Chilling thrillers of hard-boiled killers became bestsellers. It was all too much. I had to get away.
like Tom Zane before him, and maybe they'd be happy once again. Just one shot, one more chance for him to save their marriage. Away from the city, a romantic getaway. We'll be right back.
didn't see that coming. A vision.
Such a dark place, am I trapped in here? Is this real? I cannot remember. There was a manuscript, it held a key. A vicious cycle I must not surrender to.
Echo seems to seek out again and again until I figure it out to bring this song to its end.
The gates to the platform were closed. I had a ticket. Something about the station platform felt significant. It would work in my writing, but I needed more. Something lingered here. A half-forgotten memory. An echo.
Inviting me to draw an obscene picture on the city map. Caldera Street Station. The name made me think of the exit wound of a bullet.
I had a flash of inspiration. The ghost of my fictional detective. A story thread I could use in my writing. I had a location. I had a story thread. The dark place reacted to my story. The way into the tunnels was no longer blocked. The tracks led into the tunnel. That was my way forward. The blood trail continued deeper into darkness.
Out of that.
The tunnels were a maze. The blood trail led me on. Another place to use in this story. I needed to search the tunnels for further visions. Inspiration for the story that would lead me deeper. I changed the story. And with that, the dark place changed. Another echo lingered here, a source of inspiration.
Hellbird is, your research can help me, ma'am. What do you know?
There's more than one urban legend about the Cult of the Word. The murder cult used these tunnels for their ritual sacrifices. They say the cult reenacted the murders in Alan Wake's crime books. That Wake was even involved somehow, under a false identity. Mr. Scratch, which is, of course, a nickname for the devil himself.
It was disturbing finding myself in the story this way. But I was desperate, and it felt right for the story. There was something hidden here. A phrase repeated over and over. The words resonated with meaning. Had I written this? I had a new idea, a new story thread. I couldn't add a new element from here. I'd have to go to the scene. The water was gone. The way forward was open. Someone was humming. Was it worth the risk to go see who?
Hello.
Oh, hey, Alan. You snuck up on me.
Sorry. Have we met?
Memory problems again, huh? Yeah, we've met. Tim Breaker. We've shared notes. Hey, I've made some progress on the map, if you want to take a look. I still haven't found my mystery man, though.
You're making a map?
Trying to. It's hard to map a dream, though. I keep ending up in unexpected places. I find interesting things like those strange markings that react to the light, but never the one thing that I'm looking for. Feel free to check the map out. Oh, I've been stockpiling supplies while I poke around. If you find a stash, take anything you need.
I appreciate the help. Who's this mystery man?
Oh, it wouldn't be much of a mystery if I knew. All I have is a name. Warlen Dorr.
The talk show host?
No. No, that doesn't sound like him. The guy has many disguises, but a talk show host? No. I'll keep looking. Oh, that's my crazy wall. I'm just trying to make sense of things. Don't judge me.
I'll trade you walls any day.
Around, Alan.
The train blocked my way forward, but it was here for a reason. It had a role to play.
I had a new idea for a scene.
This would move the story forward.
Torchbearers living in the tunnels. They lock the poor folks up in a derailed subway car, douse it in gasoline. Yeah.
Charming.
It turns into a bit of a ghost story after that. They say the dark smoke from the fire still roams the tunnels searching for new victims to devour.
There are no happy endings in this city.
The story thread felt important. I could use it in one of the scenes I'd found. This new plot beat would carry me deeper into the story. A sick and twisted story. But it worked.
The subway car had become a burnt husk. I could get through it now. My path was blocked. I had to find a way through. The lights would help me. The Echoing Hall had a story to tell. new scene to use, a new setting. The hall had changed into the murder cult's hideout. Plot changed the details of the world.
The Fed had witnessed something here that made him run scared. Whether the summoning ritual had been a bona fide supernatural event or the mass psychosis of stark raving lunatics, it didn't change the facts. The cult was messing with things no one should mess with.
The ritual was a vital part of the story, the key to reaching the murder site. The plot element I found would drive the story forward.
This is the ritual to lead you on.
But it's not the story we need.
I'm gonna go.
only ones using the tunnels. Hidden graffiti signs marked secret routes. I kept hearing whispers around burn barrels of an underground society of mystic outsiders with hidden knowledge. Typical New York.
I couldn't hear the dark presence. It was gone. The tunnel was open now. I had seen it before. I remembered now. It was always out there, haunting me.
closest to home. An FBI agent? Who are you?
What is this? Who are you?
She can hear me.
I'm Saga Anderson, FBI.
This is Alan Wake. I'm trapped here. The Dark Place. Under Cauldron Lake.
Cauldron Lake. Who are you?
I'm trying to escape. I'm making progress, but I'm in danger. The Dark Presence. Help me. Please, help me. I could sense it. I was closer to home. Had the woman in the vision helped me somehow? Something had changed. Outside. Parliament Tower. Where I had lived with Alice. It was out there. Waiting for me.
Something had soaked into this place on a molecular level, overlapping with your meaningless existence. Regression to something you had managed to forget. Marking you. Taking you for a ride. Making you crazier.
The station had changed. I was closer now.
Overrider, I write. Writing is the key. Art is the key to find my way out of the Dark Place. I can't forget this. Don't you fucking forget this. I'm in the Dark Place. I'm outside time and space, outside reality. But this is real. A nightmare dimension, an ocean of darkness. Remember, it's dark energy can make art come true, make dreams and nightmares come true. Yes, I can use this. I need to use this. Hungry, monstrous things. Out there, wanting to stop me. To devour me. Become me. Oh no.
Parliament Tower, our home in New York. Was I really this close to being home? Going up to our apartment? Would I be home?
Or was this just an echo of the real thing? Even then, the murder site had brought me one step closer to escape.
Maybe he was the monster behind it all. Either way, Alice Wake, his ex, she knew things. It was there in her art for all to see. A cry for help. The darkness she'd witnessed. And that put her in danger.
Was Alice here? In the story?
Alice's photo equipment, set to go off when the door opens.
Get out! Leave me alone!
Alice! Alice!
This is a photo of Scratch. How did Alice get this? Is he stalking her? Alice's memory card.
To New York thinking I'd make it as an artist. and then I met Alan. We had a good thing. We were both dedicated by our creative ambitions. The only difference was that Alan's work made money. He brought me work when he could. I took his promo shots, created covers for his books. I'm sure he forced his publisher into it. I was taking photos, just not my photos. And that nod at me. Things got complicated sometimes, but that's life, right? We loved each other. Then Alan hit a block. It brought out a meaner side of him. One I didn't like. I set up a trip to see a doctor in Washington. I didn't tell him until we got there. We argued. Things went wrong. And he was just gone. Drowned, allegedly. Easy for people to think it was my fault. Hell, I do, too, sometimes. About 6 years ago, I started hearing noises in the night. Typewriter keys clacking. Voices. Alan was back. Haunting me. Then it got violent. It was Alan. And yet, it was a monster. He always did have anger in him. I set up cameras around the apartment with motion sensors and flashes. Now, when the monster comes, I turn it into art. My nightmares caught on film. And this is the focus of my new exhibition. To show people the world is so much darker than they ever knew. I'm calling this exhibit The Dark Place.
Alice. Scratch was terrorizing her. Why? I sat in the writer's room and wrote a story. Initiation. To project myself through the dark place, to look for a way out. The story had brought me here, brought me nowhere. Looped me back. I was writing this story, and in the story I now stepped into the writer's room. But there was no one here writing.
Thank you. Mr. Wake. Alan. We've seen our share of batshit crazy in the past 24 hours. What I want to know is, why am I? Why are we written into this story?
I think I saw you. Or a vision of you in the dark place. I think you helped me reach out and escape somehow. With that in the story, Scratch would have edited it to get to you. To hurt you. We are all in danger.
It's insane. And there's so much of it. Have you ever heard of the Cult of the Tree?
Creepy bunch. In the habit of wearing deer masks, performing murder rituals, victims turning into monsters possessed by darkness. Possibly inspired by a horror story written by a certain author. Ring any bells?
The cult. Yes. Yes. They have the clicker.
If the cult has the clicker, does that make them Scratch's followers? How are you so certain they even have the clicker?
They could be working for Scratch. I don't remember. It's all confused.
Alan, if I'm gonna act on this information, you need to be honest with me.
Yeah, of course.
Is he confused? Or is he hiding something? Wake said the cult has the clicker. How does he know?
The writer is the reader. The next chapter, the next chapter, the next chapter. Keep the pages safe, the dark shining of the words.
Wake is hiding pages. That's how he knows the cult has the clicker. Wake has a double. Mr. Scratch. Where is he now?
A cloud of wrath wears my face. The dark place in your place. Scratching out my body of work.
Scratch is here. In Washington. He's hunting Wake. Scratch looks just like Wake. Why?
Don't wake up the dreamer if your life is a dream. I swam to the shore, but the water is rising.
Wake and Scratch are clearly connected. Maybe Scratch got out because Wake did. Or vice versa. Wake just gave us a lot of information. But this clicker seems like a good place to start. If we find that, then we find the cult.
The cult. Yes. Yes. They have the clicker.
doesn't look right. No. Okay, Mr. Wake. I know you have more pages of the manuscript on you.
You don't understand how vital these pages are. They're the only way I can know what's coming.
You're not the only one trying to solve this. This is our job.
Okay. Here. Now, this is all I have. Be careful with them.
Inside the trailer, at the outskirts of Watery, Saga had seen Wake's fabled clicker for the first time, in the hands of the cult of the tree. A cultist stared at her. She drew her weapon.
The cult of the tree has the clicker Wake told me about. They're a part of all this. It's all on the page. The clicker, the cult. Okay, I'll head to Watery and find this trailer. Casey, you stay here and keep an eye on Mr. Wake.
Got it.
No, you need me there.
No dice, pal. This is an FBI investigation, and I don't see a badge on that flannel.
Hi, welcome.
Okay. Past favorite Deerfest floats. Go.
The yarn puppet monstrosity.
The stuffed moose and squirrels one.
No, thank you.
Hello, and welcome.
This is the third time I've requested something be done about the TV in my room. It keeps going on by itself. It's keeping me awake all night.
Yes, sir, I'm terribly sorry for that. We called a professional electrician. In the meantime, have you tried unplugging the TV for the night?
Oh, there's an idea, Einstein. Why don't I just get rid of everything?
Yeah, Anderson, I didn't want to say this in front of Wake, but are you sure this is a good idea, going on your own?
Assuming we believe the page, I need to check this out. We need to find the cult. Anyone we meet here could be a member. And this Scratch guy.
The evil doppelganger? Must be true. or else this guy can't write for shit.
The quality of his writing aside, if this page turns out to be true like the rest have, this could be a breakthrough. We might solve this thing before a backup even arrives.
They're taking their time, so just be careful out there. Meanwhile, I think me and Wake will have a chat. Maybe I can shake something loose.
Okay. But remember what happened with the salt shaker.
Yeah, real funny.
The page placed me in a trailer, somewhere in Watery. I should ask around. Hello. Do you have a second?
Long time and no see, Miss Anderson. Thor and Odin are not here. They are old tricksters always sneaking off.
Sorry. No, I wanted to ask you about something else. Can you point me to any trailers around here?
Sure. Watery Lighthouse Trailer Park. Ilmo Koskela owns it. He owns many things in town.
And where is Ilmo?
I saw Ilmo and his brother at the bridge. Well, what used to be the bridge.
Saga! Over here!
Hey, Ilmo. How did your walk in the woods with Steven go?
Another satisfied customer. I just hope he remembers to write a good review on the webpage. Great to see you back in Watery, Saga. Everyone in town missed you.
Super nice to see you again, Saga.
They act like they've known me for years. This keeps happening. You own the trailer park, right? Mind if I take a look inside?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the owner of the Watery Lighthouse Trailer Park, me, can help you with that. It's good to have our funniest resident back.
Resident? I don't understand what you mean.
If this is your way of getting out of any outstanding bills, don't worry. They've been handled. Must be hard coming back to where you and your little girl lived.
It's like they remember a different reality. Is the horror story messing with their memories? So what is Coffee World?
You mean you haven't seen our commercial for it? Coffee World is a smooth blend of rides, food, and fun. We even had a real moose. Until recently. Plus, right next to Coffee World is the workshop of our own Kalevala Knights Motorcycle Club. We're busy building the floats for Deerfest.
Don't go peeking, though. You know, we're saving the big reveal for Deerfest.
Are you familiar with the Cult of the Tree?
Yeah, we always thought it was an urban legend. Kids drawing creepy symbols to scare each other, but now it's gotten pretty damn real, huh?
It's terrible what happened. We're all in shock.
Well, we're looking into it, hoping to get things back to normal soon.
We're all for that. As normal as it ever gets around here.
So, your commercials?
They're more than commercials, Saga. Our goal is to both entertain and educate local viewers about the fine products and services we provide. And, Yako here really comes alive in front of the camera. Really.
Fuck off. I'm just there for the free beer. Not sure what Ilmo's excuse is.
Hey, I'm writer, producer, co-lead, director.
do yourself a favor and check them all out.
I need to figure this out with profiling. Elmo thinks the cult is just an urban legend. Or does he?
There are things that go bump in the night. It's all true. It's all true. Sound the alarm, brother. Gather the troops, brother. Yako, the shadow of the forest is creeping closer.
They don't think it's an urban legend at all. They understand it's dangerous. Ilmo made it sound like I lived here. Does he really believe that?
Light, laughter, and love will guide you home. Saga and her daughter. Oh boy. Happy faces raise property value. Family comes first, Ilmo. We take care of her trailer while she's gone. She's one of us, Yako. Her spare key is safe and sound.
The Koskala brothers have happy memories of me living here. This must be the story affecting them. I'll play along for now. I need the key to that trailer. A trailer park is a good place to look for a trailer. Keep it simple, Saga. All joking aside, yes, I would like to see my trailer. Do you have a spare set of keys?
Good for you. Yeah, I have a spare set. They're just over at Coffee World. I'd get them for you, but Yako and I have to head to Bright Falls. The spare keys are in the gift shop safe. I'll call ahead and have someone get them out for you. Oh, the road's flooded, but if you just follow this trail behind me, it'll lead you there.
Call the gift shop so they can give Saga a hand.
Yep.
There's Coffee World.
What am I?
Need to get across the river.
Guess they're busy. I think of it. Well, after they fight, we got to.
What was that? Fuck!
FBI, show yourself!
And sheltered with mama's pretty stories, and you're all made up fury.
And mama gave me a magic clicker. Well, yes, I think it's true and fair to say.
We'll be right back. drawn to stories early on. My dreams would light up my imagination. And you had nightmares night and day. Yeah, but with the clicker, I chased those frights away.
Ooh, you.
So true.
So here. Chilling thrillers of hard-boiled killers became bestsellers. It was all too much. I had to get away.
Yeah. he could write a new story like Tom Zane before him, and maybe they'd be happy once again. Just one shot, one more chance for him to save their marriage. Away from the city, a romantic getaway.
was pretty good. A vision.
Such a dark place, am I trapped in here? Is this real? I cannot remember. There was a manuscript, it held a key. A vicious cycle I must not surrender to.
Echo seems to seek out.